So what is going on, everyone? This is Fabi here, and Apple just announced iOS 14 yesterday, and they actually released a beta for us to use. So I actually have the beta here on my iPhone 6s. Now, this is the oldest iPhone that is supported by iOS 14, and so I thought it would be interesting to see just how it performs on this phone, which is at this point 5 years old. Now, before we start, I'm going to tell you that this is not my primary phone. I used this with iOS 13 as a secondary phone, and it really served me well. There weren't any slowdowns or delays. It wasn't the fastest phone out there, of course, but considering it's a phone that it's now 5 years old, as I said, this is really remarkable. All right, so we aren't going to do any benchmarks, but I'm going to show you just how fluid the interface is and how the features that have been added basically work on the new iPhone. So let's start with the app gallery, which is over on the right side, and you can see smooth animations even when I tap on a folder. So let's go to utilities. Oops, and I actually just opened an app because there's the three apps over in the top left corner which open directly when you tap on them because they're considered to be the most used apps. So if I tap on the bottom right corner of the folder, you can see that it opens up and it's really fluid. There's absolutely no slowdowns or glitches. I just opened another one of these applications again, but you can see it's really smooth, it works well. Now we are going to try and use the new Siri interface on iOS 14. So let's ask Siri what the weather is going to be like tomorrow. What's the weather going to be like tomorrow? Wow, that was actually really smooth. Like, you can see the animations, the way the notification popped up on the top part of the screen. This is really great. As you can see on the first screen, I have some widgets here so you can cycle through them. It works again really smoothly. Like, you wouldn't expect this from a 5-year-old phone, at least I don't, because back in the day with updates, iPhones just tended to get really slow, but now it's not the case anymore. So you can see it's really smooth. We can check out the translate application. So let's see, how are you? Translated into Spanish. There you go, we got the translation. Now that we basically looked at a few of the features that are new in iOS 14, let's try and just use the operating system as you would day to day. So let's open up some apps. Let's see, what can I open from here? Let's open up, for example, Discord. You can see it takes a little bit, which is the issue with older phones, but navigating the OS is just smooth. It just opening up applications that sometimes takes a little bit longer. But even so, you can see it works pretty fast. Like, this is not something that you would get frustrated at. So let's try and go back into an older app. Let's see. Let's try and open up this one. It basically just started right where we left it. Let's go now into Apollo, my favorite Reddit application. As you can see, nothing happened there. So as far as I'm concerned, even for a first beta, this is really smooth and really stable. You can see opening up the control center, doing all sorts of things on this phone. It really is pretty good. I don't have much to complain about. Now again, this was not meant to be a comprehensive review of iOS 14 or even an overview of iOS 14. This was mostly meant to see what sort of performance we can get from the 5-year-old phone now running the latest and greatest iOS version. Keep in mind, all of this is while screen recording so that I can show you. This also takes a little bit out of the performance, but it's really not something spectacular. From what I've gathered so far, iOS does a really good job of recording the screen without affecting the performance too much. And so yeah, I'm really astonished. I remember the iOS 4 and iOS 4S days when new updates, especially towards the end of the life cycle, would make the device basically unusable. But with iOS 14 and the iPhone 6s, as you can see over here, there's really not much of a reason to upgrade at this point if you still feel like this phone can last you for at least one more year. Now, if the battery is a problem for you, yes, maybe look for an upgrade. If you really have the cash to blow, then of course the newer iPhones are always going to be faster and shinier. But this, as regular day-to-day phone, is still quite literally perfect in my opinion. And from what I've seen so far, there really isn't any difference between the performance on iOS 13 and the performance on iOS 14. So that is really great. Kudos to Apple for pulling it off. And yeah, this is basically what I wanted to show you guys. Now, those of you that watch my videos regularly will see that I have a new monitor right behind me. Now, this is a 49-inch 32x9 screen. I'm going to do a first impression video. I'm going to do a review video. So if you want to see those videos, make sure to stay tuned for more awesome content and stay tuned for more. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like this video, share with your friends on Facebook and on Twitter, and subscribe. It really does help me out. Thank you guys and stay tuned. Peace out, guys. Peace.